if you don't have an alignment to the customer's need, then, you know, what's the point? So understand how to solve the business problem and truly align with them and understand where they're coming from.
So in this field of artificial intelligence, a lot of nerdy people and engineers, they're not, I would say, the typical sales people, including myself. You know, why they should care about sales automation in general? Like, what is the pitch for the nerd?
Sales keeps the world going round. So without sales, there's no company. And so I've always learned from my very early days that if you can impact revenue, then there's always going to be a need and a place for your services. So if you can work with someone like me to understand what the business pain is and the business value that's required, then, you know, you might as well make a small percent of a very big number instead of a large percent of a small number. Sales isn't going away. It's getting more and more automated. And if you can understand and partner with business people who understand sales, man, there's a lot of work around AI that can be done over the next decade.
So what it is kind of your top secret to sell technology? What would you recommend that?
When I was a kid, I was kind of nerdy as well, by the way. It may not outwardly appear so in my new life, but when I was age 14, 15, 17, 18, I mean, I was in calculus, advanced math, and, you know, studied really, really hard. I liked Rubik's Cubes back in the day, right? Solving a business problem. And so if your goal is to help a company solve a problem, that's the number one secret, is that you gotta align with the customer first. And a lot of companies come in and say, oh, let me tell you all about my product. It's so cool and it's fancy and it does all these things. If you don't have an alignment to the customer's need, then, you know, what's the point? So understand how to solve the business problem and truly align with them and understand where they're coming from. That's the number one biggest trick that I've learned over the years.
And what is the number one mistake not to make in sales, in your opinion?
It's kind of the opposite of that. If you go in and your goal is, hey, thanks for coming, let me do a screen share and tell you, you know, we started in 2017 of December. We signed up 30 customers in 2 months and then 100 last year. They don't care about that. So, you know, you don't want to tell. You want to show up to understand. And really all it takes sometimes is 3 slides. Here's what you told me you needed. Here's how we're gonna solve that problem, and here's the business impact if you solve that problem, right? If you just focus on doing those 3 things, you'll avoid showing up and throwing up is the biggest problem I think salespeople have.